Tom Rosano, and I'm toxicologist and director of the National Toxicology Center at the Center for Medical Science. I'm also professor of laboratory medicine at the Albany Medical Center Hospital and College. High-resolution mass spectrometry started in our laboratory at the medical center about 7 years ago. And at that time, the application primarily used in it was for medical examiner work, death investigations, and the testing of postmortem specimens. High-resolution mass spectrometry has been applied very heavily in screening because of its ability for full spectrum capture, because of its ability for high-resolution determination of mass and the identification of a molecule based on its elemental composition. So the applications have been in the area of broad-based screening. We evaluated the use of high-resolution MS for our postmortem work and continued our understanding of the use of LC-MS now in high-resolution mode as a tool in postmortem tox for screening. We began many years ago with GC mass spec, demonstrated that nominal mass, LC-MS, could be used in a screening mode. And now, at this particular point in time, about 7 years ago, looked at high-res in terms of the applications. High-resolution mass spec is both a complement and a replacement for nominal mass. It's certainly many of the tasks nominal mass does very well, and especially in terms of the quantitative side. But at the same time, initially, we looked at high resolution more in terms of its use in screening. And in that mode, it is a higher level of screening capability than nominal mass, was our conclusion from it. And what we found was that we added an ability for our confidence level in drugs because we were not only detecting the drugs, but now we were detecting multiple metabolites of those drugs through the high-resolution MS. Another advantage of high-resolution MS comes when you really think of true general unknowns, where you are not limited to any library, but you want to investigate and interrogate any finding that you get in terms of ions and in terms of peaks that are come out chromatographically. And this is where high-resolution mass spec really is really the only source of information that can move to that particular level. In the case of high-resolution MS, the data management is really the critical aspect of this. In order to use it not only as a screening tool with high resolution and the ability to get identification of fragments with exact mass fragments, but also the ability to elucidate unknown peaks, all that requires very advanced software. We are gaining significant knowledge now with the both instrumentation and software, and are now reaping the benefits of that use of that knowledge and use of that system. For high-resolution MS work, we're currently using the Acuity UPLC iClass Zevo G2 XS QTOF. Along with that, we're using the Unify software system. We're fortunate now to have the kind of technology in high-resolution MS that will allow us to interrogate and elucidate new agents. The world that we live in terms of need for identification of new drugs is an ever-changing world, one in which the new analogs that are coming forward, whether they be fentanyl analogs, cathinones, buprenorphine analogs, any of the new agents that may be currently coming out, we need to be ever vigilant for the identification of new agents. In death investigation, when the fentanyl analog usage became very high, we were initially unaware because of our targeted approach that did not include these particular agents. It is only through the ability to actually interrogate unknown peaks and to investigate their elemental composition and then to actually simulate their fragmentation, all done with software support, does it allow us to come to an understanding of potential agents that are out there? So high-resolution MS has been a very valuable tool in that regard. New software really now allows us to essentially go out to the internet to look at 5 million compounds, to compare it to our analyte, and to very rapidly interrogate and elucidate the structural information that can bring us to a high probability for the agent itself. We're using it very routinely for that. As we gain knowledge on new agents and we gain the reference materials associated with them, we then incorporate them into the library, another advantage of the system for a very easy incorporation, an incorporation along with a mole file that allows structural information regarding that particular compound. So it is a very powerful tool. It does take a great deal of software, and it does take an investment in time to learn how to use that software effectively for practice. High-resolution mass spec allows the identification not only of the mass with great accuracy, but it also gives other information that is important molecular information. It gives information on the isotope pattern and abundancy, which are important pieces of information in the identification process. So obviously basic chromatographic RT information coupled with the molecular species and its mass, coupled with fragments and their exact mass, coupled with isotope patterns, you can see how we have now developed a much greater molecular understanding of each drug and how, as an analyst and a certifier, you can have greater confidence as you review that more extensive data on the molecular side of that particular drug or metabolite. In current practice toxicology, we are continually confronted with new agents, designer drugs, illicitly produced agents from laboratories that are producing these agents, and they are causing adverse effects in our population. The most dramatic adverse effect is death. We have seen a very dramatic increase in the number of fatalities associated with what has been called the opioid crisis. It essentially has been, for a period of time, the fentanyl and fentanyl analog crisis. And it is these agents that, as they come and they're newly synthesized or newly derivatized to be a new agent, we need to be able to identify them and to be able to report in death investigations their involvement in those. High-resolution mass spec is a very essential tool for identification of new agents. We are continually confronted with designer agents and newer agents that are coming into to the region. They are not only in our death investigation in terms of findings, but they are also in our community. So they're in our court-ordered related testing. And we need the ability to adapt very rapidly to new agents. High-resolution MS, with its ability for elucidation of drugs and new drugs, is really a major tool in that approach. Use of our mass spec data in a court of law is an important element of what we do. The documentation and the litigation packages associated with our work are critical in terms of really forensic defensibility of our methods. We have a progression of use of mass spectrometry that has been going on for a number of years. Quadrupoles, ion traps, and now the ability for higher resolution using time of flight. These are all mass measurements, which all need to be validated in our laboratories, which need to be driven by SOPs and need to be documented in a manner that is defensible and usable in court-related systems. So I think that we all have the need, no matter what technology we're using in our laboratory, to be forensically defensible. The use of high-resolution MS methodology is linked really to having a library. And it's not a library just of the elemental composition of a drug or a metabolite. It's a library that provides information about the major fragments of that particular drug or metabolite. And it's not experimental information on fragments, it's exact mass data. High-resolution MS libraries are critical to the successful development of methods. They include not only the molecular species in terms of that library or the elemental composition of that drug or metabolite, but it includes exact mass fragments. Without those, we would not have the kinds of criteria that we now use for the identification of drugs and metabolites. We've been collaborating with Waters for a number of years, and we're fortunate to be able to also collaborate as we developed high-resolution mass spec. To me, that was almost critical because of the learning curve that went through in terms of the application of that particular technology. I'm still on a learning curve, and I think just like in toxicology, after many, many years, I'm still on a learning curve relative to drugs and their interpretation. And we've made a great deal of progress, in my view, from that collaboration. The analytical tools that we use in our laboratory are critical to us being effective in our mission in forensic toxicology. The use of Waters equipment, in my experience, has been a critical element in terms of applying techniques that can be effective for our laboratory. The relationship in terms of the support is an important for all of our laboratories in whatever instrumentation that is used, but it's important that we have application support, it's important that we have instrument support, it's important that we have software support, and it's important that we have a work with an instrument organization that actually brings scientific knowledge to us and works collaboratively with us. I think that's been critical to us, and I think it's been critical to the success of using Waters instrumentation in our laboratory for drug testing and the services and our mission.